Hello, everyone. Welcome to All Star Wrestling. This is Vince McMahon standing alongside wrestling great Pat Patterson here at ringside. And this week on All Star Wrestling, scheduled to join us, certainly no friend of yours, Pat, but a great wrestler, not necessarily the master of the Cobra Clutch, referring to Sergeant Slaughter.
Vince, every time I have to sit behind a table and commentate on his match, I really get the shake because I would like to be in the ring. I would love to be in the ring with Sergeant Slaughter, but I have to sit back there and watch him. And I know that Sergeant Slaughter will go out there and put the Cobra Clutch on somebody. At least he will try and look at me and just aggravate me.
Well, I'm sure you will, however, enjoy the appearance of Pedro Morales on the card.
Well, Pedro Morales, a good friend of mine, and I've always enjoyed watching him wrestling. Pedro Morales doesn't back up from no one, and he's my book, he is a true champion.
And also scheduled, ladies and gentlemen, as we brought out last week, a tremendous tag team title matchup. Tony Garea and Rick Martel putting the tag team championship on the line against Rex and King, the Moondogs. We will take you back to that match that happened very recently, and we will also show you the matchup with the Hangman, opposed by the 8th, 9th, and 10th wonders, all rolled into one, Andre the Giant. And Andre is just unbelievable, isn't he, Pat?
Vince, Andre will go on forever. He's such a big man and strong. He keeps himself in good condition. And there again, there's another man that doesn't back up from anyone. And this match with the Hangman will be very interesting.
No doubt of it. So we'll have our first match in just a moment with Pedro Morales when we return with more of All-Star Wrestling.
Greetings, wrestling fans. Welcome to another action-packed card of All-Star Wrestling promoted by Phil Zacco. These matches are sanctioned and supervised by the State Athletic Commission. J.J. Binns is the commissioner. Chief deputies in attendance are Billy Longo and Peter Lash. Timekeeper at the bell, Mike Mittman. The attending physician is Dr. John Woods. The referees assigned by the State Athletic Commission are Freddie Sparta, Danny Davis, Dick Worley, and I'm your ring announcer for All-Star Wrestling, Gary Michael Capetta. The first match in the ring is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing to my right, from Lyndhurst, New Jersey, weighing 235 pounds, Jerry Johnson. His opponent, from Culebra, Puerto Rico, 241 pounds, the current Intercontinental Champion, Pedro Morales.
Pedro Morales signing autographs, and wherever Mr. Morales goes, the autograph hounds are all over him. He is really a popular athlete. This, of course, the non-title match. Pedro getting set now to take on Jerry Johnson. Mr. Johnson looks to the referee as if there's something wrong with what Pedro Morales did.
And he's complaining that Pedro is pulling his hair or pulling his tights, and Pedro doesn't have to do things like that, and he's not doing it. There again, complaining that Pedro is doing something wrong.
Pedro working on the left arm. Shoves him to the ropes. Snap, over he goes. Yanked his hair, Morales did as well. When you're snapping somebody over like that, Pat, not that it's always that legal, but it's always nice to have a nice handful of hair, isn't it?
It helps an awful lot, I'll tell you.
Johnson quickly headed to the ropes.
Every time Pedro breaks gives a clean break, breaks on the ropes. He's very, very careful. He always steps back very slowly. And this is what a real champion should be doing.
Regular face by Johnson. Pedro returning the favor. Ooh. To the rope. Oh! Smack of the flesh to the midsection. He really buried the left hand in there. Pedro, of course, a left-hander. When he goes to work on you. Ooh, my goodness. That's going to be a broken rib, I think.
That was one heck of a backbreaker, I'll tell you that.
Pedro with a very, very easy victory over his opposition, Mr. Johnson. Perhaps we can have an interview with Pedro in a moment.
The time of the match, 2:35, and your winner, Pedro Morales.
Pedro victorious. Let's go to slow motion action now. Here, Johnson, you can see that Johnson certainly was no match for Pedro Morales. And there, boy, I'm telling you, the momentum taking him all the way down. Look at Morales just dumping him off to the side like that, covering him, hooking the leg now. Taking no chances, making sure that he was going to pin his man and get the match over. A very, very easy victory for Pedro Morales. And now, if we may, let's go to our guest, Pedro, and, of course, Pat Patterson.
Thank you, Vince. Ladies and gentlemen, Pedro Morales, the Intercontinental Champion. Pedro, we all know that you like competition when you step in the ring, and obviously this week you didn't have too much competition. But now, talking about competition, guys like Angelo Mosca, Stan Hansen, Hulk Hogan, they all would like to get a shot at that belt that you have. But they say that Pedro Morales is running away from us. Now that I don't believe.
You know, first of all, I don't care what they say. You know, I never run. I've been wrestling for a long time, Pat, and I wrestling the best, you know, all around the country, not only around the country, but many different country, you know. And I want to say something to King Kong Mosca. Listen, you big bitch, if you want some part of Pedro Morales, the only thing you have to just sign a contract with the promoter, and I go be right there in that ring.
Well, this is what we wanted to hear. Vince, we'll be right back.
All righty, we shall return with Sergeant Slaughter in a moment.
The following attraction is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from Puerto Rico, weighing 220 pounds, Angelo Gomez. His opponent, being led to the ring by his manager, the manager of champions, the Grand Wizard of Wrestling, from South Carolina, 272 pounds, Sergeant Slaughter.
This man would win certainly no popularity contest in the World Wrestling Federation. Slaughter preparing to take on Angelo Gomez. Slaughter, locking up now with Gomez. Takedown. Smile on the face of Sergeant Slaughter. Apparently thought that was pretty easy, Pat.
Well, it was, Vince. He did that very easily. You know, fans are calling in Gomer. I think Rat would be a better name for him.
Well, I'm sure there are a lot of names for Sergeant Slaughter.
Yeah.
Grand Wizard, look at all the medals dripping off him. Word to the wise. Unusual takedown, look at that.
As sort of much as I hate to say it, Vince, and I've said it many times before, the Sergeant Slaughter, when it comes to wrestling, he knows all the ins and outs of wrestling. He can do it all in the ring.
Keeps glancing over this way, too, Pat. One, two, all right. Well, that certainly brought this capacity crowd alive. And Slaughter having a few choice words for the referee. And perhaps there was a little faster count than usual. Oh, come on. Ramming that big knee into the small of the back again. Well, you could permanently injure someone by working on the back. What a body slam.
Vince, Gomez, without a doubt, is going to have a hard time walking for the next few days.
Slaughter ramming the knee into the chest area now, going from the one side of the body of Gomez to the other. Gomez, no match thus far for Sergeant Slaughter. Look at this. Slaughter pushing just as far as he can.
Well, Vince, he knows that Gomez is injured, and he just wants to punish Gomez.
And I caught him off guard. Look at this. Gomez sending Slaughter face first to the buckle. Kick to the ribs. Gomez, an elbow to the back of the head. Angelo Gomez with another right hand in the back of the head. Winds up Sergeant Slaughter. Slaughter whipped for the buckle. Boy, what a turnaround this is. Slaughter firing off with a series of rights, knocking Gomez down. Gomez whipped to the ropes. Slaughter. Oh, God. Dang.
Looks to me like...
wait a minute. Here it comes. There it is. There's the Cobra Clutch.
Well, Vince, that Gomez just about has a broken neck by now, and he puts on the Cobra Clutch. There's no way for Gomez to get out of there.
Boy, Gomez. Boy, what punishment he took. For a moment, it appeared as though we're going to have an upset in the making, though. Let's get the official time.
The time of the match, 4 minutes, 22 seconds. The winner on submission, Sergeant Slaughter.
Sergeant Slaughter victorious. Let's go to slow motion action now. The Grand Wizard should be infinitely proud of Sergeant Slaughter. Gomez to the roof. Now watch this. Let's take it all the way. Unbelievable. Slaughter. Annihilating Angelo Gomez. And then from there, of course, the infamous Cobra Clutch slap there on Angelo Gomez. On the victory, Sergeant Slaughter. We'll be back with our special interview. Stay with us. With us now, ladies and gentlemen, the Grand Wizard of Wrestling, along with Sergeant Slaughter. We would like to take you, Sergeant Slaughter and Grand Wizard, back to a recent happening when, in fact, Pat Patterson challenged you in the Cobra Clutch Challenge, and as far as many people are concerned, indeed, broke the Cobra Clutch.
No. Wrong. Absolutely wrong. Wrong.
You're telling me that these thousands of people are wrong?
Wait a minute. Let's start from the beginning. Wrong. Patterson did not challenge the sergeant. We challenged Chicken Little. Chicken Little came out from behind the microphone. The sergeant applied the Cobra Clutch, and Patterson said, "I give up," and the sergeant then released the hold. That is what happened.
And you're going to verify that, of course.
I just like to say, all you maggots, listen up now. I'm going to tell you the truth. I'm only going to tell it to you one time. Now listen up, animals. Pat Patterson went to interview me because some goofy wrestler with a mask ran off from me, wouldn't allow me to put the Cobra Clutch on him. Well, I went down and I went to talk to Pat Patterson, and I got to thinking he's as yellow as his hair is. So I took it upon myself to slap him right across the face. And I gotta say, it felt good in my hand. And it took that, and not only my 10,000, but it was part of the Grand Wizard's 10,000. The general put up 5, I put up 5. Then we got in the ring, Pat Patterson, and like the general said, I put the Cobra Clutch on you. I put it on stronger than I've ever put it on any man. And I wanted to put you out of wrestling for good. And when the time came, you tried everything you could, Pat Patterson. You were well prepared. You were just waiting for the time for me to challenge you again. I knew you were ready, and don't make any excuses saying you weren't ready. But when the time came, you tried to get out of the hold. I have to admit, at least you tried. You tried. But when the time came, the Grand Wizard, the general, my general, and I heard you. You said, I give up. I give up. I don't want to have any more punishment. So I let it go. And with a parting knee to the gut, that's what happened. And I'm telling you, on my father's grave, that's what happened.
Well, let me tell you something, Sergeant Slaughter. Pat Patterson, whether he broke the hold or not, Pat Patterson would like to have you one-on-one in the squared circle, brother.
He wants to wrestle me one-on-one. Well, anytime you can get a match, Pat Patterson, in any arena in the world, I'd like to have it right here in the East Coast, because I want to prove one thing, and that's for certain, that I will defeat you, and I will again apply the Cobra Clutch to beat you. Because if I can't beat you with a Cobra Clutch, I'll leave this area. I'll leave. Shut up, you maggots. I'm not going no place. Don't worry about it. The Wizard, the General, and I have got a movement going, and we're not leaving any place. In fact, I'll give you a challenge, Pat Patterson. In our next encounter, if you should want to, I don't know if this guy's speaking the truth. I don't think you really want to get in the ring with me. But if you do, Pat Patterson, how's it sound, General? 25 grand?
Absolutely. What? $25,000.
That's ridiculous. You guys didn't pay off on the first bet. I mean,
he lost it. Why should we pay off? We pay off on winning.
Look, Pat Patterson doesn't care about the money, doesn't care about the Cobra Clutch Challenge. All he wants is this man in the ring. That's all he wants.
Anytime he wants him, let him take off his chicken suit and sign the contract. We're not afraid of him at any time.
Let's do it right now. Where is he? Where is he? Let's do it right now. Come on, Pat Patterson. Let's go. Come on,
chicken.
Out.
Chicken. Chicken.
Come on.
Chicken.
We're going to do it.
We'll be back. We'll be back in a moment.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, it is scheduled for one fall to a finish. But first, the manager, Captain Lou Albano. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this contest is a championship contest. It is for the World Wrestling Federation's Tag Team Championship. Introducing the challengers in the corner to my left, weighing in at a combined weight of 614 pounds, Hiravi Moondog. And just ready to step into the ring are the World Wrestling Federation's tag team champions from Auckland, New Zealand, weighing 244 pounds, Tony Garea. And his partner from Quebec City, Canada, weighing 234, Rick Martel.
Two of the finest tag team champions to ever wear the World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship belts, Tony Garea, Rick Martel, laying it on the line this week against Rex and King, the Moondogs. You heard the announcer, one fall will do it. We're just about ready for the action to commence. Martel looking very, very good.
Looking very cautious, Vince, and that's one thing they must not do. They cannot be too over. They cannot be over cautious. That could be very dangerous, also.
Good job by Martel. Nice arm drag. Martel really looks like he has it going for himself.
Oh, there's no question in my mind. They feel very confident that they're going to win this match, Vince.
Rex Moondog now against Tony Garea. Garea back to the corner. Another capacity crowd here joining us this week. Nice reversal by Garea. Ooh, ran right into that. Rex drops, no, misses with the elbow. King Moondog in, and luckily, Garea able to tag Martel. Boy, Rick Martel is a house of fire.
He sure is, Vince. They are so proud to be champion, Vince, and they talk to me a lot, and they are so proud because that's one thing they always wanted. Look at that speed.
Tremendous speed, tremendous balance and agility. Martel and Garea have it all as a combination.
That's one thing they wanted for a long time. Team up together and become the World's Tag Team Champion. Their dream came true.
Garea, Martel adding a lot of dignity to the World Wrestling Federation tag team. Cover now, one, maybe two.
Captain seems to be very calm.
That's unusual. Martel and Garea functioning very well as a team. Drop toe hold, nice takedown. Right on top of his man, Rick Martel. Thus far, the Moondogs' quest for the tag team title has brought them close, but no championship. There's almost a desperation attempt on the part of Albano and the Moondogs. It It was, of course, a Lou Albano tag team combination that Tony Garea and Rick Martel defeated for the tag team championship. The Samoans, they were really rough. Nice move by Garea. He'll hook him. No. Rex missing with the elbow. Garea and Martel are sharp. Definitely very, very sharp.
Especially this week, Vince, they really got to be on top of everything. They really got to be on their toes. And that's exactly what they're doing. Captain Lou Albano starting to worry a little bit.
Off the ropes. Right hand misses. Back from the far side. Connecting Rick Martel. Big King Moondog now. Arm drag takedown. Very quickly done.
Well, so far the Moondog have not looked too well, Vince. Huh?
They don't seem to have the coordination like Garea and Martel do.
Maybe they're too anxious, or the World Tag Team Champion are just too much for them. Captain Lou Albano really starting to worry now.
Yank of the hair, referee breaking it up. Martel and Garea have been working on this one particular hold. Both teams appear to be showing quite a bit of caution. Neither team wanting to make the mistake, the one mistake that could cost them either the title or another shot at the title.
Putting a lot of pressure on that arm, Vince, ever since the beginning of the match.
Garea almost knocked down. That big 300-pound Moondog. Oh, nice maneuver by Tony Garea. Off against, over now, back from the far side. Oh, sunset flip, two. Boy, was that close.
It sure was, just a split second. Back on the arm again with Rick Martel. Vince, I'm telling you, I kind of hate to repeat myself. They are just a fantastic team. They are doing exactly what a good wrestling team should be doing.
Albano up on the steps now. A little closer to the apron now, backing off.
He is starting to worry, and I don't blame him.
Breaking the face by the Moondog. Tag made by Garea. Uh-oh, referee apparently didn't see the tag. The referee's discretion, so very, very important in every tag team match. Oh, wow.
Well, this referee, Vince, is there to do the right job, and he's a good referee.
Things turning around for the Moondogs. Cover, one, two. No. Martel and Garea defending a title, and Martel is hurt. Double team. Albano with a cheap shot. Well, you just know he'd get in a lick or two.
Oh, Vince, Tony Garea is very frustrated. You can see it on his face. He made a legal tag. The referee did not see it.
Woo.
Right now, he would be in the ring. But this you can't help. Martel really in trouble now.
Martel put on brakes. King Moondog tag. Tony Garea, no. Almost, so close. So now the Moondogs continue to wear down. Rick Martel. Blatant choke out for a moment.
Vince, I'm telling you, Rick Martel is going to have to tag pretty soon or something is going to happen.
The Moondogs tagging off with quite a bit of frequency.
They know they have Rick Martel in trouble. They're not going to stop. They can smell that belt.
Tony Garea getting in a few licks in his own. Backed up by the referee. Martel now whipped to the rope. Waiting. Nice kick by Rick Martel. No, tag was not made. They have come so close to tagging Martel and Garea. Rex Moondog off the rope. Oh, my goodness, Martel went flying. Cover, one, two. Boy, was that close. Tag was made, King coming in. And look at Rex hanging on to Martel.
If you can tell, Martel is hurt. He really wants to go and tag. He really wants to get out of there.
One, two. Wide open, Rick Martel.
The Moondog will not stop. They can smell the championship. They know they have Martel in trouble, and they will keep on him. If only could Rick make the tag, things will turn all the way around.
Martel trying to make his way over, trying to counter the attack. Kick to the midsection. Martel again. Martel with a right hand. Martel trying to tag Garea. No. Martel gallantly hanging in there. Out back door. Here's
his got it.
To the rope. Back body drop. Abdominal stretch. King Moondog in. And Martel coming drop kick. King goes out. Blatant chokehold by Garea. You can't blame him. Garea.
I think he accidentally hit the referee while he was. Here comes that suplex.
Martel going to work on Albano. Oh my! King Moondog with that bone struck Garea.
I can't believe it. Vince, I can't believe it. That Moondog came in from the outside of the ring with that bone and hit Tony Garea on behind the head, and Tony Garea is out right now. We have new World Tag Team Champions. I can't believe it. Everyone in this arena is stunned.
There is a time, 12 minutes and 4 seconds, and the winners, the new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champion, the Moondog.
Oh, no. This can't be happening. This is some kind of nightmare. The Moondogs can't be tag team champions.
I can't believe, Vince. People are kind of upset at the referee. You cannot blame the referee. The referee was knocked down accidentally. By the time he turned around, Garea was covered by one of the Moondog. All he had to do was to count one, two, three.
All right, let's go to slow motion action. Perhaps we can pick up what happened. So here we go, slow motion action. The referee knocked down inadvertently, I suspect, by Garea. Back body drop. You see, Albano was going to interfere. Martel let him have it. King Moondog has the bone. Look at him striking Garea right behind the head. Then rolls Rex over across. King then distracts Martel so that Martel won't interfere with the count. And the referee regaining his composure, put the three count on Tony Garea. Let's go back to the ring. And Garea still being helped by Rick Martel. Garea is hurt. You saw what happened with King coming in and striking Garea right across the back of the head. Oh, this is a travesty. This is one of the bleakest, darkest days in pro wrestling history.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, the next contest, it is scheduled for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the corner to my right, from the French Alps, weighing 475 pounds, ladies and gentlemen, the eighth wonder of the world, Andre the Giant. And his opponent, in the corner to my left, from Europe, weighing in at 290 pounds, here is the man who is known in the wrestling world as the Hangman.
The Hangman with a golden opportunity to defeat the otherwise undefeated Andre the Giant. He has his opportunity right about now. Here we go. Side headlock now by Andre the Giant.
Well, for a long time, and everyone has talked about how powerful the Hangman is. Well, ooh.
You were saying, Pat?
I was saying, for a long time, everyone says that, been talking about how powerful the Hangman is. Well, he has a chance to prove it tonight. Maybe we'll have a chance to see how powerful he is.
Hair pull by the Hangman. Admonition by the referee concerning a hair pull, and Andre is going to give him more than a friendly warning. The other Hangman's specialty is the Hangman hold. I don't think, Pat, as big as Andre is, that the Hangman would ever be able to apply the hold. Andre's feet would still be on the canvas, I would think.
Yes, Andre is too tall and too big to apply that kind of a hold. He's gonna have to do something else. And so far, he has not been able to do anything.
Hangman, having his problems.
There's a new twist.
No pun intended. Andre's hands immense. Of course, it goes along with the rest of him. He's just an unbelievable phenom.
You should see him you should see Andre dial a phone. It's really a trip. And the way he holds the receiver in his between his fingers.
I would imagine the receiver would disappear in his hand. His hands are so big. Forearm uppercut. Hangman on the ropes.
Oh.
Andre toying around, it appears, pretty much with the Hangman. I thought we'd see more of a match, really, Pat.
Yes, I would think so. Hangman has started to open up now.
Headbutt by Andre. Hangman falling backwards. Whip to the ropes, Andre chops him down. Andre sending a Hangman to the rope again. Oh my. Uh-oh. Oh, right across the head. Andre the Giant victorious over the Hangman. We'll get to the official time in a moment.
It is a time, 4 minutes and 1 second, and the winner, Andre the Giant.
Andre victorious. Slow motion action. Here we see, Pat.
Look at that foot right in the face.
Andre putting the final and finishing touch on the Hangman. Andre, the most phenomenal athlete, undoubtedly, of all time. Once again, victorious here on Championship Wrestling. Scheduled up next, we'll take another look at the Hawaiian, who's making quite a reputation for himself as well, Don Morocco. And of course, the crowd's still buzzing. Boy, can you believe the tag team title changed hands?
It really stunned me. I can't believe it. What happened?
The next match is set for one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing in the ring, parts unknown, weighing 234 pounds, the Black Demon. And his opponent, he will be led to the ring by his manager, the manager of champions, the Grand Wizard of Wrestling. He weighs 247 pounds. From Sunset Beach, Hawaii, the Magnificent Morocco.
The Magnificent Morocco. Good-looking young athlete. Rather unusual style in terms of professional wrestling technique. And the Grand Wizard, as soon as he's finished, will have some action in there. Morocco pouring it on. Oh, what a rushing slap.
Well, then, Demon's got to weigh 240 pounds, and Morocco just picked him up very easily. Morocco is a very versatile wrestler. He can go in the ring. If you want a brawl, he'll give you a brawl. And if you want to wrestle scientific, he can do that also. He's very, very versatile. Can actually tell he's just came in from Hawaii. Had a beautiful suntan.
Yes, indeed. Count of two. Oh. You see all sort of unusual things when Morocco's in there, Pat.
He does, Vince. He has.
There you go again.
What a very unusual move that he created himself. Very quick, very aggressive.
Morocco hit the hardwood floor out there.
I tell you, Vince, many times when you get thrown out of the ring, you know, you're at your elbow on a cement floor, or your head or your knee. I tell you, it's so dangerous to get thrown out of the ring.
Well, Demon certainly having his problems with the magnificent Morocco. Off the rope and missing. Demon catching him off guard, backs him to the corner. Nice reversal by the Demon.
Don Morocco with that thumb again. Now, I don't care what anyone says, that should be illegal, Vince.
He's using it as a spike, more or less, isn't he?
It sure is.
Morocco continues to apply more pressure. Morocco's smile on his face. He certainly likes his work.
The time of the match, 2 minutes, 32 seconds, and your winner, the magnificent Morocco.